أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
قل إنما أنا بشر مثلكم يوحى إلي أنما إلهكم إله واحد، فمن كان يرجو لقاء ربه فليعمل عملا صالحا ولا يشرك بعبادة ربه أحدا.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. جزاكم الله خير for coming and ask Allah bless you. We stopped the last time with a hadith of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, when Allah سبحانه وتعالى will bring the one who memorized the Quran and he will ask him, then he will say, I will memorize it for your sake. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say to him, you lying. And the angel will say to him, you lie, because you read it, you memorize it, and you recite it in order for the people to say about you, you are a reciter, you are a qari. The second part of the hadith about the one Allah give him money, then he does not do it for the sake of Allah. He was using it also for the people to say about him that he is generous. Allah will say to him, you already did that in order for the people to say about you that you are a generous man. And the third one, the one who killed fi sabilillah, then he will say, I was killed for your sake, ya Allah. Allah will say to him, not if you did that in order to the people to say about you, you are a brave man. And Rasulullah said in this hadith, أُولَٰئِكَ الثَّلَاثَةُ أَوَّلُ خَلْقِ اللَّهِ تُسَعَّرُ بِهُمُ النَّارُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. He said, these kind of people is the first three people will be the hellfire, start with them, heated up and started with them. In another hadith, Allah will say, اذهبوا إلى الذين كنتم تراؤون في الدنيا فهل تجدون عندهم جزاء. Allah will say to them, look to and go to the people you already were showing off them, will you find any reward with them? Then we move to some of the action done by the people and with their intention. Ibn Abbas said, some people they will do a good deeds which should be done for the sake of Allah alone, like the sadaqah and do good to the people and not doing zulm, but they don't want the sawab and the reward of it in the hereafter. They only want it from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the reward of these good deeds, to protect his money and to also increase it and to have good health and good wealth and being happy and protect his own family and having more of the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon them. But he have no, as Ibn Abbas say, he does not, because you should do the good deeds in order to have the reward from Allah and waiting the reward from Allah alone, sincerely to him, waiting the reward from him in the hereafter. But those people, they do it and all of their intention to get a reward in dunya. And they don't think about akhirah, they don't think about al-jannah and so on. We already explain all of this with the details until we come to the Abdullah, the real worshiper of Allah Azza wa Jal. Abdullah man yurdihi ma yurdi Allah, the one who will be happy with whatever Allah be happy with, and he will be angry with whatever make Allah angry, and he will love what Allah love, and he will hate what Allah hate, and he will be also friend to the one who friend with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he will be enemy to the enemy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He will not be related to his own self. Then now we will explain the ayat of Allah Azza wa Jal in the Quran al-Karim in Surah Al-Ahzab, verse number 36, and the Surah number 33. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, وَمَا كَانَ لِمُؤْمِنٍ وَلَا مُؤْمِنَةٍ إِذَا قَضَى اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ أَمْرًا أن يكون لهم الخيرة من أمرهم ومن يعص الله ورسوله فقد ضل ضلالا مبينا. It is not for a believer, mu'min or mu'mina, man or a woman, when Allah and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam have decreed a matter. If they decide something, that they should have any option in their decision. They do not have anything else. If Allah decides something, رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم decides something, this is the believer, the one who believe in Allah, the one who believe in رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, the one who love really Allah, he love رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, he will follow. He will love what Allah say, he will love what رسول الله say, he will follow it, he will prefer it more than anything else. As Allah already say, they have no choice other than what Allah say, they have no choice other than what رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم say. And whosoever disobeys Allah and disobeys Rasulullah, he has indeed strayed into a plain error. He's going wrong. There is no any doubt. Because the best thing and the right thing to follow what Allah say, to follow what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say. Listen also to Ibn Abbas. When one time he was talking about tamattu' bil-umrati ila al-hajj, saying the best thing to do tamattu' in al-hajj, because we know that we have a three different kinds. There is a tamattu' or qaran or ifrad. And it will come to the time we'll explain it inshallah. Then Ibn Abbas, when he told them that, they said, oh, we heard Abu Bakr and Umar saying so and so and so. He said, يوشك أن تنزل عليكم حجارة من السماء. أقول قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وتقولون قال أبو بكر وعمر. He said, nearly it will come a punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon your head. I am saying to you, Allah said and Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, and you say Abu Bakr and Umar said and did. That means what? When Allah say, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, leave anything else and follow what Allah say and follow what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say. Listen to Surah An-Nisa, verse number 59 till number 65. Seven different ayat talking about this point. From An-Nisa, Surah number 4, verse number 59. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, يا أيها الذين آمنوا أطيعوا الله وأطيعوا الرسول وأولي الأمر منكم فإن تنازعتم في شيء فردوه إلى الله والرسول إن كنتم تؤمنون بالله واليوم الآخر ذلك خير وأحسن تأويلا. أيوه بليف أبي الله أن أبي رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم and those of you the Muslims who is أولي الأمر. الأمر هنا أمر الدين. The people of religion. The people who will guide you to Allah. The people who will lead you to Allah. Lead you and make you close to Allah. Close to رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. The people will tell you what Allah wants from you. What about if you have differences and dispute about something? Some people saying this way and some other people saying this way. Already Allah has already decided. And if you differ in anything amongst yourselves, refer it to Allah and to Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. Go back to what Allah say. Go back to what Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم say. Refer it to what Allah say. Refer it to what Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم say. If you believe in Allah and in the last day. This is the ayah, the meaning of the ayah. That is better and more suitable for final determination for you. Allah says this is the best thing with you is to see what Allah say to you. If there is dispute, there is differences. Some people saying this way, some people saying this way. Look what Allah say. Look what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say. Then practically do it and leave any other thing. In Surah An-Nisa, verse number 60. أَلَمْ تَرَ إِلَى الَّذِينَ يَزْعُمُونَ أَنَّهُمْ آمَنُوا بِمَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكَ وَمَا أُنزِلَ مِن قَبْلِكَ يُرِيدُونَ أَن يَتَحَاكَمُوا إِلَى الطَّاغُوتِ وَقَدْ أُمِرُوا أَن يَكْفُرُوا بِهِ ويريد الشيطان أن يضلهم ضلالا بعيدا. الله سبحانه وتعالى now in this ayah, النساء verse number 60, talking about the منافقين. Allah say, have you not seen those here المنافقين, the hypocrite, who claims that they believe in that which has been sent down to you? They claim that they believe in Allah and believe in Rasulullah and believe in whatever revealed to you. Believe, they claim that they believe in what Allah said. And that which has was sinned down before you. And they wish to go for judgment in their disputes too. If there is dispute, they wish to go to at-taghut. What is at-taghut? كل ما عبد من دون الله فهو طاغوت. Anything worshipped other than Allah is taghut. Like shayateen, like the human being, like the idols, like the sun, like the stars, the angels, the tombs. Anyone who ruling you by other than the what Allah say, كل ما عبد من دون الله فهو طاغوت. and from the human being, especially if he accepted. He accepts and he calls the people to worship him. This will be taghut. He calls the people to worship him, or he calls the people to worship other than Allah, or he calls the people to do other than what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say. This will be, Allah named him taghut. They go to taghut while they have been ordered to reject them, while they are ordered to not to believe in them, not to follow any taghut. But the shaitan wishes to lead them far astray.
It's 10 o'clock.
Shaitan wishes to lead them far astray. In Surah An-Nisa, verse number 61, the next ayah. Listen to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say.
وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ تَعَالَوْا إِلَى مَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ وَإِلَى الرَّسُولِ رَأَيْتَ الْمُنَافِقِينَ يَصُدُّونَ عَنْكَ صُدُودًا.
And when it is said to them, come to what Allah has sent down, and come to what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam called you to do, you will see المنافقين, the hypocrite, turning away from you with aversion. يَصُدُّونَ صُدُودًا. Allah affirmed that they will prevent the people from you, and they will be sure to do it. They will not only prevent themselves, they will try to prevent others. Oh, don't listen to him.
In Surah An-Nisa, verse number 62, فَكَيْفَ إِذَا أَصَابَتْهُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ بِمَا قَدَّمَتْ أَيْدِيهِمْ ثُمَّ جَاءُوكَ يَحْلِفُونَ بِاللَّهِ إِنْ أَرَدْنَا إِلَّا إِحْسَانًا وَتَوْفِيقًا.
How then, when a catastrophe, a calamity befall upon them, because of what their hands have sent forth, because of what they did, they come to you swearing by Allah. They come to Rasulullah, swear by Allah, we mean no more than goodwill and conciliation. They say, oh, we mean good and we're doing good. A lot of people where they are doing bad and evil, they don't feel that they are doing evil and wrong. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say in the end of Surah Al-Kahf,
الَّذِينَ ضَلَّ سَعْيُهُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَهُمْ يَحْسَبُونَ أَنَّهُمْ يُحْسِنُونَ صُنْعًا.
Those who are going astray in this dunya while they think that they are doing good. While they think that they are doing good. In Surah An-Nisa, verse number 63, Allah talking about those who go opposite of what Allah say, go opposite of what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, and also they prevent the people from, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say in verse number 61, when it is said to them, come to what Allah saying, come to what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, the munafiqin, they will prevent the people and prevent themselves from following.
أولئك الذين يعلم الله ما في قلوبهم فأعرض عنهم وعظهم وقل لهم في أنفسهم قولا بليغا.
They, those munafiqs, the hypocrite, are those of whom Allah knows what is in their hearts. So turn aside from them. Allah say at this time to Rasulullah, do not punish them now, but admonish them, advise them. It is our duty in front of Allah to give the message to the people. Allah said so and so and so. Rasulullah said so and so and so. And la ikraha fi al-deen. There is no force in religion. But everything must be clear that whatever you are doing is not acceptable. Whatever you are doing is not what Allah say, is not what Rasulullah is saying. And speak to them in an effective word. Believe in Allah alone. Do not do shirk. Obey Allah. Fear Him. Have more taqwa to reach their inner selves. In Surah An-Nisa, verse number 64, Allah said,
وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ رَسُولٍ إِلَّا لِيُطَاعَ بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ وَلَوْ أَنَّهُمْ إِذْ ظَلَمُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ جَاءُوكَ فَاسْتَغْفَرُوا اللَّهِ وَاسْتَغْفَرَ لَهُمُ الرَّسُولِ لَوَجَدُوا اللَّهَ تَوَّابًا رَحِيمًا.
We sent no Rasul but to be obeyed by Allah's permission, by Allah's leave. Allah sent the messenger and sent a lot of miracles with him, and sent the Quran with him, and no other messenger sent the holy book with them in order for what? For the people to obey them. And when you obey them, you are obeying the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
And if those munafiqeen, the hypocrite, when they had been unjust to themselves, had come to you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and begged Allah's forgiveness, and the messenger had begged forgiveness for them, indeed they would have found Allah all forgiving, most merciful.
Listen to the next Surah An-Nisa, verse number 65.
فَلَا وَرَبِّكَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ حتى يحكموك فيما شجر بينهم ثم لا يجدوا في أنفسهم حرجا مما قضيت ويسلموا تسليما. But no, by your Lord. They can have no faith. They can have no iman until and unless they make you, O Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, judge in all disputes between them and find in themselves no resistance against your decisions and accept whatever you decide. Accept them with full submission. With a full submission. These ayat in a total effect. What does it say? Saying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put a system. And this system is complete and perfect and Allah happy and satisfied and want you to follow it. This complete and perfect system. Allah want you and order you in the Quran Kareem and Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to tattabi' in Arabic wala tabtadi' ittabi' follow wala tabtadi' do not innovate and create new things. Inshallah will explain more about also the saying of the Imams themselves, like the Imam Shafi'i, the Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, the Imam A'zam ibn Hanifa, the Imam Malik, what they said. They order us already, all of them without exception. If you find what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, and if you find what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, and you find our own saying is not according to what Rasulullah say, even Imam A'zam ibn Hanifa said, even according to what the Sahaba say, leave my saying and follow them. This is a safety for them and safety for you. Safety for them in front of Allah, they will say already we told them. I'll bring the details from everyone who say, Imam Shafi'i what he said, Imam Malik what he said, Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal what he said, Imam A'zam ibn Hanifa what he said, with the details. If you leave what Allah say to follow anybody else, Allah consider it as a shirk also. As if you are leaving what Allah say and worshipping this man. You are leaving worshipping of Allah, because obeying of Allah is worshipping to him. If you leave what Allah say after it become clear to you with the proofs, authentic proof from Quran and Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam say, and follow what these people saying, doesn't matter who is he, you are like worshipping them, and there is proofs from the Quran al-Kareem about that also. When Allah talking about other religions before, they take their rabbis and they take their own monks as Lord beside Allah. One of them, he came to Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم and he said, Ya Rasulullah, ما عبدناهم. We did not worship them. We did not prostrate ourselves to them. Rasulullah explained it to him. Did they make what Allah make halal? They make it haram to you and you follow them? He said, yes, we did. Did they make whatever Allah make haram? They make it halal for you. Whatever Allah forbid, they already say to you, what is allowed, you can do it. Then you followed them. He said, this is the real worshiping of them. When you leave what Allah say, when you leave what Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam say, then you follow somebody else which it is against of. I am not saying do not follow mazahib. You can follow the mazhab, there is no problem. But if there is something already proved that is in this mazhab or out of the mazhab somebody created later in it and proved that it is not according to the Quran and Sunnah, the believer will leave what anybody else say and he will go strictly follow what Allah and what Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying. With these ayat and with these ahadith and with this idea, I will stop and inshallah in the next time I told you, I'll bring to you what Imam A'zam Abu Hanifa said and what is the source of Sharia, Quran of Allah, Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the ijma' of Sahaba and the ijma' of the ulama of the ummah and going on. And la ta'ata li makhluqin fi ma'asiyat al-khaliq. There is no any obeying for any makhluq to disobey al-khaliq. There is no any obeying for the creator to disobey the one who is the creator, subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We will stop with that and we will go on, inshallah, with more details. Allahumma inna nas'aluka bismika al-a'zam alhimna rujdana wa'izna min sharri anfusina ya rabbal alameen. Allahumma inna nas'aluka ilman nafi'an wa na'uzu bika min ilmin la yanfa'. اللهم رب السماوات السبع ورب الأرض ورب العرش العظيم ربنا ورب كل شيء فالق الحب والنوى ومنزل التوراة والإنجيل والفرقان نعوذ بك من شر كل شيء أنت آخذ بناصيته. اللهم أنت الأول فليس قبلك شيء وأنت الآخر فليس بعدك شيء وأنت الظاهر فليس فوقك شيء وأنت الباطن فليس دونك شيء. اقض عنا الدين واغننا من الفقر يا رب العالمين. اللهم ألف بين قلوبنا وأصلح ذات بيننا واهدنا سبل السلام يا رب العالمين. اللهم إنا نسألك بأن لك الحمد لا إله إلا أنت وحدك لا شريك لك الحنان المنان يا بديع السماوات والأرض. ألف بين قلوبنا وأصلح ذات
الصلاه بيننا واهدنا سبل السلام ونجنا من الظلمات الى النور وجنبنا الفواحش ما ظهر منها وما بطن وبارك لنا في اسماعنا وفي ابصارنا وفي قلوبنا وفي ازواجنا وفي ذرياتنا وتب علينا انك انت التواب الرحيم واجعلنا شاكرين لنعمك مثنين بها عليك قابلين لها واتممها علينا يا رب العالمين. اللهم انا نسالك باسمك الاعظم خير المساله وخير الدعاء وخير النجاح وخير العلم وخير العمل وخير الثواب وخير الحياه وخير الممات، وثبتنا وثقل موازيننا وحقق ايماننا وارفع درجاتنا وتقبل صلاتنا واغفر خطيئتنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم انا نسالك اجعلنا واهالينا وبلادنا وبلاد المسلمين واوطاننا يا رب العالمين في ضمانك وامانك واحسانك وحفظك ورعايتك ونصرك وتاييدك، واغفر لنا وارحمنا. اللهم ارحمنا رحمة من عندك تهدي بها قلوبنا وتجمع بها أمرنا وتلم بها شعثنا وتحفظ بها غائبنا وترد بها الفتن عنا وتعصمنا بها من كل مكروه وسوء. وصل اللهم على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا، وجزاكم الله خيرا وبارك الله فيكم، والسلام